Previously on General College.
By the way, I feel too young to be called Professor Kingsley, so you can just call me Joseph.
Trisha, with you as a girlfriend, I don't have to go anywhere. Life is hell.
Alex, that's not gonna happen. You know, all the houses will probably jump at a chance to have you as a pledge.
But I think he's got a girlfriend.
How do you know?
Well, the other day I stopped by his office, and while I was there, he got this phone call.
Guess who her roommate is?
Who?
Paige. The girl I took out earlier this week.
Are you serious?
Yeah, the two girls I have dates with in 1 week are roommates.
Miss Phillips, Mr. Rice, could you please hold the conversation down until after class? Save the romance for after class, too. Thank you. Now back to American poetry.
While emphasizing the freshness of contemporary poetry, some poets and critics have argued that it reflects a violent break with the first generation of modern poetry of T.S. Eliot and Graham.
Sure.
If not, we've all changed the end of the introduction
to the
important anthology.
Yeah. I'm fine. It's just the society.
Of T.S. Eliot and the new critics has ceased.
It's confusing.
Well, it's not that confusing, really. You just write about a recent experience.
I'm sorry.
Mr. Matthews, Miss Simmons. Just what exactly is so important that you have to interrupt class to discuss? This is inexcusable. This whole class spends altogether too much time socializing and not enough time studying. Your grades show it. Let's be a little bit more prepared for class next time. Miss Simmons, I need to see you after class. Class dismissed.
Oh, no problem.
Where's Jason? Megan. I think we need to talk.
Jason?
No, I think we need to talk now.
Jason, leave him alone.
Look, wait, shut up, okay? I'll talk to you later. Meg, come on.
Jason, I've got a class. I can't talk to you now. Look, I'll come up to your room later, okay?
Okay, be there at 4 o'clock.
Okay. You wanted to see me?
Yes, I wanted to see you.
Calm down. Why are you so angry?
Don't tell me when to calm down, Sarah.
Okay. What did you want to see me about?
I can't talk here. Can we just meet in my office later on today?
Sure, I could come by around 4.
All right, I'll see you then.
Exactly.
Well, good for you. You're on time.
So did you invite me here just to watch your brilliant pitching form?
You're something else. You know that? You're really something else.
Jason, what are you talking about?
Well, what do you think I'm talking about?
Well, I don't know. Suppose you give me a little hint.
Rick, you know, you and Rick today in English?
Yeah.
Well, you should have just jumped on him right there.
You can't be serious. Rick?
Don't give me that. I saw you flirting with him.
Oh, Jason, we're just friends. He's your roommate.
Exactly.
Well, I think you give me a little more credit than to flirt with someone like Rick. But then I guess you're not exactly the discriminating type, are you? You're one to talk about flirting. I saw you in Sarah Simmons.
Oh, yeah, right. I borrowed a pin from her. It wasn't like we were exchanging phone numbers or something.
Are you jealous?
No. Okay, so what? I'm a little jealous.
All right, then. Let's make up.
I said, come in.
Sorry, I didn't hear you the first time.
Oh, Sarah, hi. I'm sorry. I didn't expect it to be you. It's just 4:30, and I thought you were supposed to be here at 4.
No, I didn't forget. I just fell asleep in the library.
Well, you certainly aren't getting very many good points in my book today, are you? First, you talk all during my lecture, and now you're late.
All during your lecture? Don't you think you're exaggerating just a little?
Look, Sarah, it doesn't matter how much or how little talking you did. What matters is that you did it in my class. And I will not tolerate it, no matter how important you think it is to talk to that guy next to you.
I'm sorry, it won't happen again.
Sarah, besides getting in trouble in class, what else have you been doing?
Nothing much, really. Just studying a lot, I guess. Well, actually, I did go to this mixer the other night at the Tri-Sci, but it was a lot of fun until I got this horrible thought.
What happened?
It's a long story, really, but it has to do with this drunk guy who wanted to show off, so he bit a beer can in two, and he was waving it around. I happened to be walking by, and he accidentally cut me with the can.
Let me see.
It's nothing, really. It's just a cut, a nick, a scratch. I didn't even...
Herbie's hotline. No, just kidding. This is Rick in Jason's room. This is Rick. Anyway, we're out killing a few cold ones. So if you're a gorgeous babe, leave your name, number, and measurements. Otherwise, you know what to do. Bye. Well, that was typical. Anyway, Jason, this is Steve. I know you don't really want to talk to me after. Well,
what was all that about?
Old friend.
Start off for the first round of Rush? I guess I should ask if there are any questions. Does anyone have any questions?
Yeah, I do. How much time do we spend at each house?
Okay, you spend 10 minutes at each house, and you have to go to every house, and just remember, I'm going to walk y'all to the houses tonight, but tomorrow you're all on your own. So just remember where they are.
Well, Jenny, when do we find out about the first cuts?
That'll be tomorrow about noon. We'll be announcing the first cuts, and that's when you find out if any of the houses cut you.
Jenny, this may seem like a stupid question, but what are we going to talk about with these girls? The sisters, I mean. I mean, normally talking is not a problem with me, but we only have 10 minutes.
Okay, it's not your responsibility. It's the responsibility of the sisters to keep the conversation going. And just remember, be yourself. Don't try to worry about thinking of anything clever to say. They just want to get to know you.
Easier to say than do.
Okay, does anyone else have any questions? Okay, let's go get our name tags and index cards. We're out of here.
Okay. She's there. There have to be others.
Yeah. Are you worried about first cuts?
I don't know. Kind of. I mean, I just hope Phi Delta got cut.
Damn it.
What's wrong?
My car. Either it's been stolen or it's been towed.
That's awful.
I thought they didn't tow on the weekends.
Well, as far as parking goes, there are no rules around here.
Well, look, I'm going to go in there and see where they towed it. You just go on back to the dorm. You're just a block away.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I can handle it.
Okay, well, I'll see you tonight around 2.
Okay, give me the dirt on first cut.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Can you talk?
Yeah, what's the matter, Paige?
Meg, who is this?
This is Prince Charming. How did you get this?
I was looking for a pin or something. That's beside the point. Meg, we have to talk.
What is the problem?
Your Prince Charming is the boyfriend.
Yes, my boyfriend,
No, mine. My boyfriend.
What are you saying, Paige?
Meg, what I'm trying to tell you is we've both been dating the same guy.
Billy's got a party we're invited.
pick me up at 10:30?
Maybe.
Hi, what can I do for you?
I need a ticket for this Friday's movie.
No, you don't.
Excuse me?
You can't have a ticket.
Is it sold out?
No, but to be honest, you really don't want to see this.
I don't?
It's bad. We get to see all the films when they first come in. No one even stayed till the end.
Well, you really know how to sell a movie, don't you?
It's a gift.
Well, then, what do you suggest I go see?
Well, right now, there's a really good film playing over at the Varsity, but if you want to see this one...
No way. Not if it's as bad as you say it is.
You know, you look really familiar. I know I've seen you somewhere. I know that sounds like such a line.
It is, but anyway, my name is Steve.
Hi, I'm Meg.
Well, thank you so much for your advice, and I guess I'll see you around, Meg.
You can count on it.
Hello, Mary Catherine. I'm Miss Friedman. I'm a nurse practitioner.
Hi.
I know this is your first visit here, and I'm sure you're probably a little nervous, but I just want to assure you that everything you say in here is confidential and you can trust me.
I guess I'm just not used to this sort of thing.
That's perfectly understandable, but just try to relax and be as comfortable as possible. It says here on your chart that you want to...
I just want to check out a few things.
Come on in. Oh, hey. So, what's up?
Look. Steve. I don't think you should call me anymore. I don't want to see you. I don't want to talk to you. I can't deal with being friends with you anymore.
But I don't want to be just friends.
I know. I think we should stay out of each other's lives. Okay, stay out of my life. Please. I gotta go.
Too bad. I know how that goes. Love stinks, doesn't it?
Did you get in a fight with your boyfriend?
Yeah, well, kinda. So what's yours about?
Well, see, there's this person that I've been in love with since high school. Mm-hmm. And I thought this person liked me too, but they don't.
Oh, that's too bad. At least your person didn't betray you. The guy I've been seeing, he's been dating my roommate at the same time.
That is horrible. At least the jerk I'm in love with wouldn't do that.
Lucky you.
No, I didn't mean it that way. I'm just in a lousy mood.
No, it's okay. Hey, you want to go get a beer?
Sure. Let's go get wasted.
Yeah, let's go.
I believe you have my car. It was towed this morning.
Really?
Yeah, a tan Regal on Franklin Street.
Tan Regal.
Did you tow it or not? I'd like to bail it out.
Yeah, we brought in a tan Regal this morning, but I'm not so sure I can let you have it.
Why not?
Well, how do I know it's really yours?
My name is on the registration.
What is your name?
Alex Whitten. What's yours?
Address?
213 Cobb.
Phone number?
Is this important? 932-3356. Can I have my car now?
Kirk, bring in the tan Regal from this morning and check the name on the registration. Should be Alex Whitney.
$25. Hey, you always so uptight?
Thanks for getting my car.
She gasped as he lifted her from the golden sand.
as he whispered into her ear seductively, "Love me, Marietta." Margaret lay on her dorm room sofa, her golden hair shimmering in the fluorescent lights, as she pondered the four men, each longing to marry her, each on the brink of inheriting their daddy's multi-million-dollar Fortune 500 companies, and each aching to buy her a Ferrari. She laughed and tossed back her head as they showered her with gifts and flowers, when suddenly in crawled Jason Matthews, looking unkempt, exhausted, and limping slightly.
Meg. Meg, it's me, Jason. Jason Matthews from UNC. Meg, I beg you to take me back. Since you left, my life has not been worth dirt. I'll always love you. I dropped out of school, and I've been living in a gutter in New York City for 2 years. But I kept up with you through the newspapers. I collected deposit bottles from garbage cans and alleys and bought newspapers to read about you and your fabulous life. I read that you graduated 2 years early from college to sail around the world with that Arabian
cheek,
and the modeling offers and the movie contracts and all those stockbrokers at your feet and their marriage proposals.
Get on with it.
I saved all my money, 5,438 Coke bottles, to get on a bus and come see you. Meg, please. Please take me back. Please. I'll never cheat on you again. I swear. You can cheat on me. Please, you can. That'd be fine, but I swear I'll never cheat on you again. Please take me back.
Someone get this trash out of the room. He's filthy. Set the dogs on him. I'm sure they'd like to play with him. Then suddenly, a stranger walked into her room. A man whose eyes saw through to her very soul. He was dressed beautifully and walked with a certain stealthy grace, as if he were a predator and she her prey. His eyes flashed as he looked at her.
Margaret.
Oh, come in.
Look, if you wouldn't tell me what's going on, or do I have to keep guessing? Now, you've been acting like this all night long.
It's nothing.
That is bull. You've been in your own little world ever since we've gone out tonight.
You're gonna hate me.
Mary Catherine, I'm not gonna hate you. If there's something wrong, I wanna know. I wanna help you.
I'm so scared.
What is it, Mary Catherine?
I'm pregnant.